Mentions in. In the Quran where he states in Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 19. Inna ad-deena 'inda Allah al-Islam. Indeed, the only deen with Allah is al-Islam. The only deen that is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Islam. No other deen is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala other than the deen of al-Islam. The Jews and the Christians are not upon al-Islam. The Jews and the Christians are not upon al-Islam. Although their prophets and their messengers, they came with the message of al-Islam, they were upon al-Islam. They called to al-Islam. They told their nations to die upon Islam. But after the prophets and the messengers passed away, their nations deviated from al-Islam. So the Jews and the Christians are not upon al-Islam. Who are the closest to the Muslims? The closest people to the Muslims are who? The Jews and the Christians. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them the people of the book. But the Jews and the Christians are not Muslims. Their prophets and their messengers were Muslims. The religion which the Jews and the Christians are upon today, the religion which the Jews and the Christians are upon today is not the religion which the prophet, their prophets and their messengers came. This needs to be understood. There are certain people who call to this Abrahamic religions. They say Islam, Judaism and Christianity are all Abrahamic religions. Now, Christianity, Judaism and Al-Islam are three different religions. They all believe in Ibrahim alayhi salam, but they are not all Abrahamic religions, because Ibrahim alayhi salam was upon Tawheed and the Jews and the Christians are not upon Tawheed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the Quran where he says in Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 67, ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. Ibrahim was neither a Jew nor a Christian, but he was a true Muslim, a Hanif. A Hanif is somebody who is free from associating partners with Allah in Ibadah. And he was not of the Mushrikun, those who associate partners with Allah in worship. So this is with regards to al-Islam. Inna ad-deena 'inda Allah al-Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the Quran where he says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَيُقْبَلَ مِنْ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And whoever seeks a religion other than al-Islam, it will never be accepted of him. So we find this, that al-Islam is the only religion that will be accepted. Anybody else that has any other religion will not be accepted. And the reason for this is, somebody may ask, why is al-Islam the only religion that is accepted by Allah? Because all the other previous religions have been corrupted, have been distorted. All the other previous religions have been corrupted and distorted. And one of the major things in which these religions have been corrupted and distorted is in the concept of Tawheed and in their position of Ashirk. So the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has rejected all other religions, and in particular Judaism and Christianity, is that Judaism and Christianity have been distorted, have deviated, have been altered, and have been changed, and have been distorted. And from the most important things that they have been distorted with is at-tawheed and ash-shirk. what has been claimed to be at-tawheed has been taken as a shirk. That their understanding of at-tawheed, of what they call monotheism, in reality is a shirk. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in an authentic hadith where he said, أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطاع إليه سبيلا. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Islam is that you testify that La ilaha illallah, none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, and to establish the prayer and pay the zakah and to fast Ramadan and to make the pilgrimage of Hajj to the house if you are able to do so. This is an authentic hadith which has been reported by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives an explanation of al-Islam. It gives an explanation of the pillars of al-Islam. As we know that the five pillars of al-Islam have been mentioned in the Quran in various places, in various ayat. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أنزل فيه القرآن يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله واستغفر لذنبك واعبد الله ولا تشرك به شيئا. So the five pillars of Islam have been mentioned in the Quran, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam categorically mentioned. He mentioned the first as La ilaha illallah. Then he mentioned Salah. Then he mentioned zakah, then he mentioned fasting, and then he mentioned hajj for the one who is able to do so. So this shows that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that al-Islam is governed by five actions and five pillars. And he mentioned these five things. He mentioned first at-tawheed, then he mentioned as-salah, then he mentioned az-zakah, then he mentioned fasting, and then he mentioned hajj for the one who is able to do so. This shows us that when da'wah, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever spoke to teach the people about al-Islam, he always started with at-tawheed. When the people understood at-tawheed, only then he informed them about salah and zakah and hajj, and salah, zakah, saum and hajj. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's da'wah would always start with at-tawheed, shahadat la ilaha illallah. This also makes it clear to us that the definition of al-Islam is different from the pillars of al-Islam. Many people get the two mixed up. When sometimes, when we find that when Jibreel alayhi salam came and asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أخبرني عن الإسلام, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered by giving him the pillars of Islam. Gave him the pillars of al-Islam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sometimes spoke about the pillars of Islam, and at various times the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke and explained the definition of al-Islam. But what is intended is that when the word al-Islam is mentioned in the Quran, it incorporates the definition of al-Islam, and it also incorporates the pillars of al-Islam. That's why we find the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sometimes explaining with the pillars of Islam and sometimes explaining the meaning of al-Islam. So what do we understand from this? We understand from this that ma'na al-Islami, that the meaning of al-Islam consists of al-ma'na al-shar'i, its sharia meaning and its pillars, wa arkan. Do we understand? Do we understand what I say, that Islam has its technical sharia meaning and it has its pillars? Sometimes the Prophet ﷺ answered by giving the answers to the pillars, by mentioning the pillars, and at times he gave the understanding, he explained the definition of al-Islam. So there is no point teaching people about Salah, Zakah, fasting and Hajj if they have not understood the first pillar, which is the pillar of At-Tawheed. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, when he said, Shaykh al-Islam, he explained when the Prophet ﷺ said, "An tashhada, an la ilaha illallah." He says, "وَمَعْنَى لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ أَيْ لَا مَعْبُودَ حَقٌّ إِلَّا اللَّهِ أَيْ لَا مَعْبُودَ حَقٌّ إِلَّا اللَّهِ," which means that there is no deity worthy of worship in truth except Allah. So this is the meaning of La ilaha illallah. The meaning of La ilaha illallah is La ma'buda haqqun illallah. The Sufis say that the meaning of La ilaha illallah is La mawjuda illallah. That nothing exists other than Allah. This is a perverted understanding and an incorrect and deviated understanding of At-Tawheed. They say La mawjuda means that nothing exists except Allah. That means everything that exists is Allah. So they believe that you are Allah. They believe everything that exists, from animals to houses to cars, Allah is within everything. That's why they say that the meaning of La ilaha illallah is La mawjuda illallah. And this is why that you find many of them after Salat al-Fajr, in particular in many of the masajid, that they make this dhikr after Fajr in the masajid, where they say La ilaha illallah. So they break the shahada, the first part of the shahada, La ilaha illallah, into two parts. They say La ilaha and they say illallah. And many of them, when they make dhikr, this is how they start the dhikr. So they will do their dhikr like this, putting their hands like this, and they will say La ilaha, they will start La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah. This is to believe that La mawjuda illallah. And then they will move on. After they get into La ilaha illallah, and after they get into the mode, and after they become sakhin, like they say, hot, then they will say illallah, 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 illallah. This illallah, illallah, illallah is to, you can say, support or to substantiate.